Hi everyone, welcome to our channel JIB and CIB Made Simple. So if you are studying for your BFM exam and need to grasp the essential concept of Exim Bank and its significance in international banking, you are in the right place. Today we will uncover how the Exim Bank along with institutions like RBI and FIDE supports India international trade. Did you know that understanding these rules can not only help you ace your BFM exam but also give you insight into the real world trade dynamics? Let's dive in. In this video, we will break down the key functions of the Exim Bank, including its financial products like buyer's credit, project financing, and how these help businesses expand globally. We will also touch on the philosophy guiding the Exim Bank operation, which focuses on enhancing India's export competitiveness. Now, why you should care? Because understanding this concept is crucial for your BFM exam and for grasping how India engages with the global market. Knowing how these institutions work together can help you choose the correct option in the examination confidently and understand broader implications for our economy. So grab your notebook and let's get started on the essential topic. If you find this video useful, don't forget to like, subscribe and share it with your fellow student who might benefit from this information. Let's jump right in. So today we will discuss 8.1, 8.2 and 8.3. These three units we are going to cover in this particular unit. So let's begin with the first topic, that is our role and function of Exim Bank. So we will talk about the key institution that plays an essential role in facilitating international trade like Exim Bank, RBI, FIDE and other related agencies. First, let's quickly look at what international banking is, because this term you will face frequently. What is this international banking all about? So think of it like international banking is all about transaction between different countries and currencies. You can think of it like how companies or government in one country. So suppose this is country one and this is country two. So how government and company in this country buy and sell goods and services with those in the other country. So in India, the central bank, which is the Reserve Bank of India, you know, it's like the boss of all international transactions. It's just like a boss of all international transactions. It controls and regulates this activity, ensuring that everything follows the country monetary and fiscal policy. But RBI don't work alone. It has support from other important agencies like Exim Bank, like FIDE and more. Let's see what these institutions are, what these institutions do and how they help international banking. First, let's start with the Exim Bank. See. So hopefully you have understood the objective of this particular topic. So now let's start with the Exim Bank. So this stands for Export Import Bank of India, which was established way back in 1981 under the Exim Bank of India Act 1981. Right. Now, as the name suggests, its main job is to promote export and import activity. But let me explain this with an example. So imagine you are a company in India that want to sell car. This is your company and you want to sell cars, right, to another country. So suppose this is country one and this is country two, right? Now you will need a lot of money to manufacture this car and transport them to, let's say, US. Suppose you are transporting to US. The Exim Bank steps in here to provide financial assistance, because you will need money, right? So financial assistance will be provided by the Exim Bank. Not just any short-term loan, but often long-term financing to help you with big project like this. So the primary role of this Exim Bank, you can see, is to provide financial assistance and coordinate export-import trade financing, especially by offering long-term loan to business. This way it supports India's economy by helping business grow global. Now let's talk about the RBI. So if we talk about the RBI, so RBI, what does RBI do? You can see RBI is a main regulator of the it is a main regulator of the international trade in India, as you know it very well, right? So it controls just like how it controls domestic banking, it also supervises the international banking, right? So that is the role of RBI. So RBI oversees a law called FEMA. You know what FEMA? FEMA 1999, that is called Foreign Exchange Management Act. This law helped regulate foreign exchange market and ensure that trade between India and other countries is done safely and legally. And last come FIDE. FIDE, another key player in the international banking is FIDE, or the Foreign Exchange Dealer Association of India. It works closely with RBI and banks setting the rules for foreign exchange transaction. For example, if you are sending money abroad or a company is making international payment, FIDAI ensure that everything is done according to the guidelines. So we have covered some key points. What is international banking? Like, it involves transaction between different countries and currencies. We have discussed RBI, which control and regulate international banking in India, and especially under the FEMA Act 1999. We have discussed Exim Bank. Exim Bank established in 1981. It provides long-term loan to support export and import. We have discussed FIDAI, which sets guideline for foreign exchange transaction, right? So this is all about this particular slide. Now let's discuss the key role of Exim Bank, right? So first of all, to put it simply, Exim Bank plays a vital role in promoting India's export. One of the key way it does this, by arranging something called letter of credit, right? By arranging something called, sorry, line of credit, right? But what does that mean? So imagine a country like Kenya. So suppose a country like Kenya, it want to buy machinery from India, right? But need financial support to do so. It does not have financial support to do that. So Exim Bank can step in and offer something called LOC. LOC means what? Line of credit, right? To the Kenyan government. This credit make it easier for them to purchase Indian product, and in turn help Indian company grow by exporting their goods abroad. So Exim Bank provides something called LOC, and this LOC helps the Kenyan government purchase the product, and this helps the Indian exporter to grow. Now besides that, Exim Bank also acts like a growth engine. You can see, first thing they offer is line of credit, second thing they act like a growth engine for a small and medium sector enterprise, that is called SME. It offers different products and services, all aimed at helping Indian business and expand internationally. So this is how we talk about. Now let's talk about what are the services provided by the Exim Bank. So let's talk about the range of services. These services are designed to cover almost every stage of international trade, from product development to financing. The first come is import of technology. So Exim Bank help Indian businesses import the latest technology from around the world. Next is export product development. So what it is? See, before business can start exporting, they need to develop and market product suitable for international market. So when I say export product development, so before business can start exporting, so before export, they need to develop and market product suitable for international market. Exim Bank support them through this process by providing funding for product development, production, and even marketing overseas. Next is pre-shipment and post-shipment financing. So when a company is about to send out goods for export, they might need fund to cover manufacturing cost or other expenses. Exim Bank offer pre-shipment financing for this. Once the shipment is done, company may also need money to manage operation until they get paid by the buyer. This is where post-shipment financing comes into picture. So Exim Bank ensure that every business have fund at every step. And the next come is overseas investment support. So if a company is looking to set up operation in another country, Exim Bank can provide financial support for overseas investment, right? This help Indian businesses expand their global footprint. So these are the way Exim Bank help the Indian exporter, like overseas investment support, pre-shipment and post-shipment financing, export product development. Now let's talk about, so why is Exim Bank so strategically important in India? Well, in today's dynamic financial landscape, international trade is the backbone of any growing economy. Exim Bank act like a catalyst, right? Promoting cross-border trade and investment. This means that by supporting Indian exporter, by offering loan and providing a strategic assistance, Exim Bank help India grow on the global stage. Whether it is small businesses trying to go international or large corporations expanding overseas, Exim Bank plays a crucial role in connecting Indian businesses and the opportunity available worldwide. So let's summarize the key point which we have covered in the previous two slides. First thing we have seen, let's quickly summarize the key point. So we have seen that Exim Bank arranges lines of credit, and also it acts like a growth engine. Then we talked about the service provided, import of technology to keep Indian business competitive, provide funding for export product development, right, production and marketing. Then comes offer pre-shipment and post-shipment finance to ensure a smooth trade. And lastly, it supports overseas investment for Indian company looking to expand internationally. A strategic importance we have discussed, that Exim Bank is a catalyst for promoting cross-border trade, helping India. So Exim Bank is much more than just a financial institution. It is a key player in Indian international trade ecosystem, right? Now let's come to the next slide and let's continue our discussion on Axis Bank philosophy products. So first thing is first take a look at the core philosophy behind Axis Bank operation. Axis Bank mission is all about boosting India's international competitiveness. You can see written here. So Axis Bank work to make Indian exporter more competitive by offering financing at rate and terms that help them thrive in the global market. Imagine being able to compete with companies from other country, not just on product quality but also on cost. This is what Axis Bank aims for. Second thing is alternative financing solution. So it also focuses on creating new and innovative way to finance export business. For example, if traditional loan are not working for company, Axis Bank can offer alternative method that to get them financing support they need. Next comes is information and advice. So Axis Bank don't just provide loans, it also offer critical information, data and guidance to help Indian exporter identify new opportunity in the foreign market. Think of it like having an advisor that help you navigate the complexity of the international trade. Next come is selective support. What does it mean? So selective support means what? You can see it written here. Selective support. See, not every product or services is supported equally. Axis Bank carefully chooses which product to focus on, specifically supporting the production, marketing and financing of those Indian products that have the best chance of succeeding internationally. It's not like that every product Axis Bank will give equal attention. No, it will give more attention to those products which has greater chance of succeeding internationally. Next, talk about problem solving and policy resolution. Axis Bank also steps in when Indian exporter face challenges, whether it with trade policy or other export related issue. They work to find solution, often pushing for policy changes that benefit Indian businesses. So now let's talk about Axis Bank financial product. So now that we have covered the philosophy behind Axis Bank, let's move on to their key financial product. The first financial product is buyer's credit, as the name suggests. What is it all about? Try to understand. See, this is an important tool designed to help Indian exporter explore and expand into new international market. So how does buyer's credit work? Let's break it down. Axis Bank offer a credit facility which is known as buyer's credit to encourage overseas buyer to purchase goods or services from India, right? So it will encourage overseas buyer to purchase goods or services from India. The goal is to make Indian export more attractive to foreign buyer by offering them flexible payment option. Imagine you are a buyer in another country, let's say Brazil. Okay, you want to import textile from India. But you don't have the cash up front. This is where buyer's credit comes into play, right? Now, so let me show you the steps of the buyer's credit. Okay, let me show you the step. How does it work? So buyer's credit mechanism. Step one is called letter of credit. The overseas buyer, let's say a company in Brazil. So this is Brazilian company, which is nothing but a buyer. So this overseas buyer opens something called letter of credit. It opens something called what? Letter of credit, right? In favor of the Indian exporter. In favor of whom? In favor of Indian exporter, it opens letter of credit, right? This LC acts like a guarantee from the buyer's bank that the payment will be made. That buyer's bank give the promise that yes, payment will be made. Now, instead of paying for the goods immediately, the buyer gets the good on deferred payment term. So what is the key term here? The key term is deferred payment term, right? So remember this, the key term here is deferred payment terms, right? So essentially, when I say deferred payment term, DPT in short, I can write it. So essentially, they get some time to make the payment, and this flexibility make it easier for them to import goods from India, right? So the benefit for the Indian exporter is that they can access new market while the overseas buyer gets favorable credit term to make the deal happen, right? So this is how it is beneficial. Now let's talk about the strategic support of buyer's credit. So buyer's credit is very strategically important. So hopefully you have understood. This Brazilian firm has opened letter of credit, which is like a guarantee to the Indian exporter, and the payment is made on deferred payment, and it will not be made immediately. It will be made after certain date. So buyer's credit is strategically important. Why? Why it is strategically important? Because two things are there. Because it promote Indian export by lowering financial barrier for overseas buyer. This facility open up new opportunity for Indian businesses. So whether it is textile, machinery or technology, Indian exporter can confidently expand into new region, knowing that Exim Bank's buyer credit will make their product more attractive to the international buyer. Right. So we'll discuss the benefit for Indian exporter. Let's summarize the key points. So first of all, we have discussed the Exim Bank philosophy: enhance Indian export competitiveness, offer alternative financing solution, provide information and guidance on export opportunity, selectively support product with a strong international presence. And we have discussed key product, which is the buyer's credit. It helps Indian exporter reach new market by offering flexible credit term to overseas buyer. Right. So now let's discuss what are the benefits for Indian exporter of this buyer's credit. So by the this financial product is designed to make international trade easier and more competitive. First thing is reduce transaction cost. So what does it mean? See, one of the biggest headache in the international trade is dealing with high transaction cost and complexities. Buyer's credit help Indian exporter reduce this cost, making international transaction more manageable. Next benefit is managing the working capital. As you can see, managing the working capital. So what does it mean? It clearly means that often exporter have to spend a lot of their working capital upfront. Buyer's credit allow them to sell their product to overseas buyer on deferred payment term, which means exporter get paid right away while the buyers pay over time. So this way business don't have to deplete their working capital. So exporter will be get paid right away while the buyers pay over the time. So the working capital does not get depleted. Now let's clear up a common question: how do Indian company use buyer's credit? So this is a question: how do Indian company use buyer's credit? So Indian company get buyer credit from international financial institution when they import good. So suppose in this case Indian company is there which is importing goods from other country. So in this case Indian company can get buyer's credit from international financial institution. However, Exim Bank buyer's credit is exclusively for the export of Indian goods and service. Remember it. Right. Now, Exim Bank plays a crucial role in the supporting small and medium enterprise, which is called SME support. So in India, by providing credit to overseas buyer, Exim Bank make it easier for these smaller businesses to export their good and services to the international trade. For example, an Indian MSME exporting, so suppose this is an Indian SME, it is exporting something called textile to Africa, right? So it can rely on Exim Bank buyer's credit to ensure that overseas buyer get flexible payment terms. This open up opportunity for SME to expand beyond domestic border. Now let's talk about non-LC transaction. So here is another benefit of buyer's credit, that it helps exporter save on LC charges. So it can help exporter on save on LC charges. In traditional LC, LC fees can add up, but with Exim Bank buyer's credit, exporter can work without LC in some case, which reduces their transaction cost further. Now let's switch gear and let's talk about another important product about Exim Bank, which is called project financing. This product help Indian companies, especially sectors like construction and infrastructure, take on large scale international project. So how does it work? Let's break it down. Exim Bank project financing is available for foreign project company, right, that award contract to Indian exporter. So if an overseas company is developing a major infrastructure project and they want Indian expertise, Exim Bank steps in to provide the financial support. Exim Bank offer medium and long term financing, right, to ensure that these projects are executed smoothly. This help Indian company carry out large international project without worrying about financing, and they also get competitive interest rate. Now let's talk about which kind of product are covered. So what kind of product does Exim Bank cover it? So here is a quick look. First is called infrastructure payment. So what does it mean? So infrastructure project means what? From highway and bridges to power plant, Exim Bank support the infrastructure project. Can that develop upgrade of facility? Next come is public and private project. So it is not just government project. Exim Bank also help finance public sector initiative, private sector initiative, whether it is building manufacturing plant or expanding existing facilities. Next come professional service. This financing also cover professional services like architecture, consultant, surveying, engineering, making Indian expertise accessible to key product. So now let's summarize the key fact which we have covered just now. So first of all, we have discussed the benefit of buyer's credit. First of all, it reduces the transaction cost and save on LC charges, help maintaining export working capital, and also provide a specific support to SME by offering credit to the overseas buyer. Now, if you talk about export bank financing project, so it is quite easy. So export, let's talk about the Exim Bank project financing. We have already covered that it provide medium and long term financing for international project, support infrastructure and other development project, covered both public and private sector project. The bank offer a special financing program for businesses in this creative sector to help them expand internationally and contribute to India's export growth. Now let's talk about this finance for the grassroots sector, grassroots enterprises. So Exim Bank don't just focus on large businesses, it also support the grassroots enterprises. These are small local businesses that have the potential to contribute to India's export economy. Through financial support, Exim Bank help these enterprise enter international market, encouraging export growth at the local level. Let's talk about the lines of credit. See, now, one of the Exim Bank most strategic tool for helping Indian exporter, LOC are all about facilitating market entry. They allow Indian exporter to India to enter new geographies, right, or expand in the existing export market by providing overseas buyer with deferred payment terms. Now let's talk about what is the importance of this LOC. See, LOC plays a critical role for Indian exporter by reducing this payment risk from the overseas buyer. Imagine you are an exporter and want to expand into a new country. Suppose the new country is Russia, right? With an LOC, you can offer flexible payment terms to the overseas buyer, which make it easier for you to enter that market. So LOC also serve as a market diversification strategy, right? By offering this deferred payment term, Indian company can tap into new region and reduce their dependency on a single market. Now, entities receiving LOC. Now, who are actually receiving this LOC? Exim Bank extend LOC to overseas financial institution, regional development market, sovereign government, and other similar entity. These organizations then help facilitate import from India, such as infrastructure project, equipment, and goods. Exim Bank work hand in hand with the government of India when extending LOC. This partnership ensures that Indian exporters are supported at the highest level, encouraging cross-border trade in a risk-free manner. Now, so how are these LOC used? So LOC allow buyers from other country to import developmental and infrastructure project from India, including equipment, goods and services, all on deferred credit term. This means buyer has the time to pay, while the Indian exporter get immediate support from the Exim Bank in form of payment. So now let's summarize the key points which we have covered till now. First thing we have seen that financial assistance to SPV. SPV means special purpose vehicle. So targeted support for cluster of SPV, right? Through cluster of SME through SPV, creative economic financing, support for grassroots enterprise, lines of credit which help Indian exporter enter new market, and they serve as a powerful market diversification tool. Now let's come to the next point, which is our Exim Bank overseas investment financing and project export. So first let's talk about overseas investment financing. The objective here is quite simple, that Exim Bank help Indian company invest abroad, right? So Indian company to invest abroad. By facilitating this investment, the Exim Bank enable Indian business to acquire a strategic asset, resources, and driving both Indian export opportunity and economic growth. For example, imagine an Indian textile company, right, wanting to expand into Africa. So with financing from Exim Bank, they can set up a manufacturing unit there, access raw material at lower cost, and export back to India or other country. This not only strengthen the company global footprint, but also bring more resources and efficiency to the Indian business. That is called overseas investment financing. Now, Exim Bank actively encourage Indian company to invest abroad. Right, it could be to secure essential resources, tap into new market, or gain operational efficiencies. This international presence make Indian company more competitive on the global stage and allow them to acquire a strategic asset that could fuel their growth. The third thing is project export. Now let's move to the project export. Exim Bank has been a major force in promoting project export from India for our last three decades. For by supporting Indian companies in securing international contract, Exim Bank is not only helping the Indian economy, but also contributing to the development goal of the host country. Exim Bank offer a comprehensive support for EPC, engineering, procurement and construction. दीज प्रोजेक्ट इंक्लूड सिविल, मैकेनिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल वर्क अक्रॉस वेरियस सेक्टर. थिंक ऑफ इट इन दिस वे, इफ एन इंडियन इंजीनियरिंग फर्म इज अवार्डेड अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू बिल्ड अ पावर प्लांट इन साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, एक्सिम बैंक प्रोवाइड देम विद द नेसेसरी फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट टू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोजेक्ट स्मूथली. सो सपोज पावर प्लांट इज टू बी मेड इन द साउथ ईस्ट चाइना और साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, एक्सिम बैंक प्रोवाइड द फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट. नाउ स्पेसिफिक इक्विपमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर, राइट. सी एक्सिम बैंक ऑल्सो सपोर्ट प्रोविजन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक इक्विपमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन? दिस कैन इन्वॉल्व एनीथिंग फ्रॉम सप्लाइंग कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल एंड कंसल्टेंसी सर्विसेज टू शेयरिंग इंडियन इंजीनियरिंग एंटरप्राइज एक्सपर्टाइज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट से प्रोजेक्ट रिक्वायर स्टेट ऑफ द आर्ट इंडियन टेक्नोलॉजी टू इम्प्रूव द एफिशियंसी ऑफ वाटर ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट. एक्सिम बैंक फाइनेंस द ट्रांसफर ऑफ दैट टेक्नोलॉजी, एंश्योरिंग दैट इंडियन कंपनी इज इन्वॉल्व इन एवरी स्टेप फ्रॉम डिजाइन टू एम्प्लीमेंटेशन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज सपोर्ट फॉर न्यू एंड एग्जिस्टिंग प्रोजेक्ट. तो वेदर इट इज अ ब्रांड न्यू प्रोजेक्ट और एन एग्जिस्टिंग प्लांट दैट नीड अपग्रेडिंग, एक्सिम बैंक इज देयर टू प्रोवाइड द नेसेसरी असिस्टेंट. दे एन्श्योर दैट इंडियन कंपनी हैव द फाइनेंशियल बैकिंग दे नीड टू कम्पीट एंड सक्सीड इन द ग्लोबल मार्केट प्लेस. सो लेट समराइज द की पॉइंट विच वी हैव कवर्ड इन दीज टू स्लाइड्स. फर्स्ट थिंग, ओवरसीज इन्वेस्टमेंट फाइनेंसिंग, राइट. सो इट हेल्प्स एक्सिम बैंक हेल्प इंडियन कंपनीज इन्वेस्ट अब्रोड, एक्वायरिंग रिसोर्सेज, स्ट्रेटजिक एसेट एंड टैपिंग इनटू न्यू मार्केट. नेक्स्ट कम इनकरेजमेंट फॉर इंडियन कंपनी. एक्सिम बैंक प्रमोट इंटरनेशनल इन्वेस्टमेंट टू इन्हांस इंडियाज कंपनी कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस एंड ग्लोबल रिच. नेक्स्ट वी डिस्कस प्रोजेक्ट एक्सपोर्ट. एक्सिम बैंक सपोर्ट इंडियन कंपनी इन सिक्योरिंग इंटरनेशनल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ होस्ट कंट्री. ईपीसी सपोर्ट, इंजीनियरिंग प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन. सो द बैंक प्रोवाइड फाइनेंशियल बैकिंग फॉर लार्ज स्केल इंजीनियरिंग प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट. नाउ स्पेसिफिक इक्विपमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर. एक्सिम बैंक फाइनेंस द प्रोविजन ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल, टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर एंड इंजीनियरिंग एक्सपर्टाइज. वेदर इट इज अ न्यू प्रोजेक्ट और एक्जिस्टिंग वन नीड्स नीडिंग एक्सपेंशन और मॉडर्नाइजेशन, एक्सिम बैंक हेल्प इंडियन कंपनी सक्सीड इंटरनेशनली, राइट. सो लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट विच इज आवर अदर सर्विसेज एंड प्रोग्राम ऑफर्ड बाय एक्सिम बैंक. सो द फर्स्ट कम इज कंसल्टेंसी एंड टेक्नोलॉजी सर्विसेज. सो मैन पावर एंड एक्सपर्ट रिक्रूटमेंट, राइट. सो इट इंक्लूड्स मैन पावर एंड एक्सपर्ट रिक्रूटमेंट. सो नीड स्किल्ड पर्सनल फॉर फॉरिन प्रोजेक्ट, एक्सिम बैंक ऑफर फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट टू रिक्रूट द राइट एक्सपर्ट. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज प्रिपेरेशन ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट एंड प्लान्स. सो एक्सिम बैंक फाइनेंस द क्रिएशन ऑफ डिटेल प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट एंड प्लान, एसेंशियल फॉर बिजनेस लुकिंग टू एग्जीक्यूट लार्ज स्केल इंटरनेशनल प्रोजेक्ट. ट्रांसफर ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, ऑलरेडी डिस्कस. इफ यू नीड टू ट्रांसफर एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी टू फॉरिन प्रोजेक्ट, एक्सिम बैंक इज देयर टू सपोर्ट यू विद फाइनेंसिंग. सो एक्सिम बैंक इज इंश्योरिंग दैट एन इंडियन कंपनी हैव एवरीथिंग दे नीड, फ्रॉम राइट पीपल टू द राइट टेक्नोलॉजी टू द सक्सेसफुली कंप्लीटिंग इंटरनेशनल प्रोजेक्ट. Now, overseas investment finance. Next, look at the overseas investment finance. Exim Bank support Indian corporate by providing equity financing for setting up joint venture abroad. So, equity finance for setting up joint venture abroad. This means, if an Indian company want to partner with a foreign firm, the Exim Bank can offer financial backing for their investment. They also participate in this venture by financing the export of plant and machinery or by offering long-term export financing for big international project. Now, let's talk about the import loan in the next slide. See, imagine you are an Indian company executing a project in a foreign country, but you need to import material or machinery from a third country. Exim Bank provide loan for this import, ensuring that the project continue without any financial hiccups. So this service is particularly helpful for large infrastructure project where material may not always be available locally. Next is international merchant banking services. So Exim Bank provide two major type of support under this program. The first is called foreign currency financing. Exim Bank offer financing in a foreign currency to ensure companies for their international project. This ensure that they have access to the money they need in the right currency without losing out through exchange rate fluctuation. Next is called advisory services. You can see written here, advisory services. See, in addition to the funding, Exim Bank also support advisory services to help Indian businesses raise low cost finance for their international project. This means they not only provide the money but also offer expert advice on how to get financing at the best rate. Now let's quickly summarize the key services we covered today. First thing is consultancy and technology service, overseas investment finance, import loan, international merchant banking services. So friends, this was all for today's lecture. We will continue the next part in the next lecture, like EMF phases. Okay, so if you feel that this content is truly useful to you, and if you want to get access to such type of English material for all the units of BFM, you can enroll in our comprehensive program. For more detail related to the comprehensive program, you can WhatsApp me on this particular number, and do hit the like button, subscribe the channel, and also